I'm going to be talking about the priestly manhood of the home and how the husbands can take their place where they're supposed to and can take the godly authority of the home. There's a lot of husbands don't do that. I used to not. I know what I'm talking about. Taking the responsibility for the family. Being a protection for the family. See, Adam was supposed to have done that. And he didn't. He flopped on his job. And you know something? The devil is still trying today to cause the men not to take their rightful, God-given authority in the home. And that's where problems arise. And that's how the enemy creeps in at times and causes all kinds of problems. But you know something? We can't take that place if we don't know how to take that place. We need to be taught, how do I stand in this place? What do I do? What is my responsibility? What is my job? Well, I'm going to be teaching on some of those things. And therefore, you can learn how to protect and cover your family, and then God can raise you up as the high priest of your home. That's exactly what He wants, what He wants you to operate in. I might as well pick on the women a minute, too, I guess. Sometimes, though, the poor old man is so beaten down, he just can't get up. I got a few amens on that one. You read back in Kings and places, you find out about Jezebel and how she operated. Sometimes there's Jezebels around today. Not the same one, but that same spirit operates in people. Amen. And I've got news for you, men. It operates in men, too.
Amen.
It can operate in anybody.
Right.
It has no favorites. It'll just go into whoever. But that needs to change, too. My wife and I were divorced for 5 years, and then God put our marriage back together. And I knew since God put our marriage back together, we'd never have any more problems. I mean, you know, God did it, you know. And then I began to pray, you know. And about 6 months into our marriage, this was in 1980, December 1980, we got married again. I began to pray and I said, God, did you send her back to me? Or did the devil send her back to me? Because it seemed like to me, all of a sudden, she got real mean on me. And it was rough. Oh, my brothers and sisters. Nobody knows. Nobody knows the trouble I've seen. Nobody knows but Jesus. Hey, listen to me. The same guy down the street's having the same problems you are. Don't think whatever it is that's happening to you, you're the only one it's happening to. The devil is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He's bothering somebody else with the same mess he's trying to put on you. Say amen.
Amen.
I used to think I was the only one in the country having problems. Always me. But there's other people having the same problems because the devil's the same. But you know something? There's help for people like that. And I'm not exalting myself here tonight and saying Ken Greene didn't have any problems because I had problems too. There's always a 50-50 deal. Can you say amen?
Amen.
I used to think it was 90% her problem until I looked in the mirror one day and God opened my eyes. And I realized I had some problems too. And I'm not going to say here tonight that deliverance is a cure-all, but it's a beginning. You have to start there. When these demonical influences are in people's lives, controlling spirits, pride, haughtiness, There's a stubbornness. There's a lot of things there that can cause problems in homes. And I never will forget, I was out in California, and Brenda called me up on the phone, and she says, my pastor's wife, she says, has started teaching on this controlling, manipulative spirit like Jezebel had. And I said, what? I said, man, I never heard anything like that where I went to school. I said, what in the world are they getting into back there? That's what hit my mind, you know. And she says, and I believe I've got one or whatever. And I said, yeah, I guess you do. But anyway, when I got home, I never will forget, I walked in the door. And as soon as I walked in the door of my house where there'd been so much chaos, where there'd been a war going on and nobody had to say a word, you could feel it in the air, the tension. All of a sudden that day, I walked into my house. I didn't know she'd had prayer for this thing. But when I walked into my house, I knew something was different. I hadn't even seen my wife yet. And then when she walked around the corner and when she spoke to me, I knew I had a new wife. Amen. That old yin, 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 yin was gone. Well, amen. Woo, glory. And I'll be honest with you, 1981, 82, and along in there, 83, I almost got a divorce two or three different times because, man, I couldn't handle it. Willie. And it was both of us. She says, I know what you mean. Well, anyway, but it was both of us. But my wife seems to think sometimes I put all the blame on her, but I don't. It was all of us. But she knows she had that thing. But I'll tell you what, it changed our lives. The delicious message changed our lives. Amen. We're together, and I've got news. If it wasn't for that, we would not be doubt about it in my mind. Well, amen.
Amen.
And you know something? I don't even know if I would be in the ministry today. If it hadn't have been for the mighty deliverance ministry that God is bringing into the church today. And folks, I'm going to say this again. It's not a cure-all. Are you listening to me? You can be delivered from these things, but I've got news for you. You've got to start changing your behavioral patterns immediately. Yes. You can't yield to those things again. You can't get in unforgiveness and bitterness and hatred towards someone. That opens the door right back up for these things. You've got to walk a holy, godly life before God to stay free from this stuff. And it's hard at first because the enemy's going to come back. He's going to come back with the pressure to try to get you to get mad at people, to say things you shouldn't. But if you walk in God and make up your mind that you're not going to yield to that anymore, then God can do miracles. And, of course, He's done that in our life. And it's just a blessing. So praise God. I'm going to be sharing a little bit also in the men's retreat about leadership qualities, some of the leadership qualities that can help you in all areas. And I'll be preaching to myself, too. Can you say amen? My name's on the list, too. So it's going to be good. I'm always preaching to myself. A lot of times after the meetings, God will speak to me and say, you need to go back and get that tape and listen to it. Yeah. Say amen.
Amen.
Because it's not coming out of my natural knowledge of your mind when you preach and minister. It's coming out of the gift of God. Amen. It's a revelation. It's a rhema. It's prophecy a lot of times, prophetic preaching. That's what we need today. To help us. Amen.
Amen.
And to set us free.